I'm feeling good, but a lot of people, everybody keep asking me, am I excited, how I feel, have anything changed? And my answer is no, because like I've been saying all along, I knew I was supposed to be being here a long time ago. I worked my whole life to get to where I am now, so I'm where I'm supposed to be, and it just feels natural and authentic.
So you've always had this self-validation, but how about all this validation of everyone else coming to you now, giving you flowers? Has that like changed your demeanor at all? Or just still
no, not at all. Yeah, it's just everybody's starting to give me my recognition for things that I already knew, for the people that around me that was in my inner circle already knew, for the people that supported Terrence Crawford already knew. So nothing has changed for us, because we already for years been saying Terrence Crawford is the best fighter in the world. Terrence Crawford is the best pound for pound fighter in the world. Terrence Crawford is the best fighter in the division. And the people that doubted me now is believers, and it's nothing new to us because we've been saying it.
Bud, I got a question for you. For somebody who's been knowing you for a long time, being from North Omaha, what do you say to the kids from North Omaha, where we're from, if they want to be the next Terrence Crawford?
I just tell them to believe, you know, believe in themselves, you know, hard work, dedication, you know, take their craft serious, do their homework, study. I would just tell them, you know, be in tune with themselves, because you know boxing is a tough man sport, so you gotta overcome a lot of adversity and trials and tribulations, not only in the ring but outside the ring. So you gotta be mentally, physically prepared for anything that comes your way. And if you don't hit all the check boxes, then one slip up can lead you to a failure.
What, 2 o'clock today, you got the showdown over at the Butler Gas with the top amateurs, not only here in Omaha, but in the region. What does that mean to you today? I know everybody will put the spotlight on you, but my great-great nephew fight over there, and I know how you shine a light on the young people. What does it mean to have them shine today from 2 to 8 over at Butler Gas?
It means a lot. You know, today is a big day. You know, we got the parade here for myself. And then we're going to shine a light on the boxing gym, B&B Sports Academy, and the kids are going to be able to display their talent in front of a big crowd. So a lot of people is going to be noticing the things that these kids have been doing in the gym, putting in the hard work, and it's going to show today.
Hey, Terrence, you know, recently throughout the week, you kind of went on a revenge tour and kind of told everyone, like, Charlamagne, like, I told you so. But with the parade, is this more exciting to do versus, like, going through that revenge tour throughout the media a few days ago?
Of course. You know, this is my city. You know, my city has been supporting me from day one, since I was in the amateurs, since 2006 when I fought in the National Golden Gloves when it was here, when I made it to the finals. So my city has always been backing me since day one. And, you know, every time I step foot in the ring, I support and rep my city, because I know my city gonna show out and support me just like I support them. So, you know, this is a great event that's happening. This is great for the up and coming kids to see. This is great for Omaha as a whole.
Lastly, at the send-off, you had the bucket hat on, fishing hat. You're wearing it here. Is that just a theme, or is that you just kind of just representing, expressing yourself? Like, you like fishing, and that's just who you've always been?
I love fishing. I don't like fishing. I love fishing. You know what I mean? This is that's something that I love to do on my spare time, you know. So when Errol said he the big fish, and, you know, I love fishing. You know, it was just the thing to do is, you know, we going fishing. So we caught the big fish like we said we was, and everything that I said from the past to the present, you know, was true and it happened. So, you know, I'm just happy that everything fell in the right place at the right time, and I got to shine on the day that I had to shine and prove everybody wrong that doubted me.
What's the atmosphere been like over at B&B? What have you been telling the young kids? Have you seen them, the trainers? Has it been fun?
Oh, it's been the same. You know, nothing's changed. Like I said, when I walk in the gym, I walked in the gym the Tuesday when I came back, and they was working hard. You know, I come in there, you know, you got a lot of young fighters. They come up to me, say, good luck, good job, you know, and I'm like, you know, keep working, you know. So everything is the same. You know, they see me every day. They see me after fights. They see me in big moments. So this is nothing new to them because they believed in me just like I believed in myself.
You got a lot of food trucks, restaurants, vendors from North Omaha represented here today. What does that mean to have them come and show out and be supportive of the community here downtown?
It means a lot. You know, a few of them, I told them they should come down here and, you know, support the event. And they was like, man, they would love to because, you know, they got a business too. And what way to support everybody and have everybody come together if, you know, you got shirts, if you got food, or you sell certain products, you know, bring it down because, you know, like I said, I do this for Omaha and we all as one, and it just come together and make it a bigger event.
Have you heard anything about the 30-day rematch clause? Is there something in the works, and is that something you'd be open to?
Well, you know, I haven't heard anything yet, and like I said before, it's in the contract, so it's not if I'm open to it or not. It's, you know, what's in the contract, and Errol gave me an opportunity and a shot at becoming the first male boxer, undisputed, you know, in any division in a four-belt era. And I honor, you know, that. And if he was to come to me or activate his rematch, then I honor it.
Hey, Terrence, first off, congratulations on the achievement. When you look at your career as a whole, for a long, long time, people knew who you were in terms of, like, skills and what you brought to the table, but in the way and the manner you did it in this fight, how does it feel to kind of finally get that validation from everyone else?
Oh, it feels great. It feels great because part of my whole career, I've been, you know, hit with the awe. He was over the hill, or he wasn't that good, or you're not fighting nobody, or you fighting tomato cans. So I was always hit with negative feedback because of how well I performed in these big fights. A lot of people, you know, they wanted to see me struggle in certain fights, but like I said before in the press conference, I never struggled in not one of my fights ever in professional. You know, I always won in flying colors. I never had a close match. I never had a match where you question whether I won or lost. So when you that much better than the competition, it makes the competition look, you know, lesser than you. So everybody felt as if I wasn't fighting competition because of how well I performed. So to be able to perform better than I was in my recent fights where they said these guys was tomato cans and they was over the hills and they was washed up and they was damaged goods. It just make it more satisfying because I can look back and say, okay, well, what about this guy that y'all said was gonna beat me? You know, I performed at a higher level than I did with the guys that y'all said was tomato can. So it's a great feeling and it's a great taste in my mouth, you know, to be able to say, what now?
You look in good shape. For maybe one more question.
Terrence, congratulations. Thank you for keeping Omaha in mind. There's not a lot of sports folks that do keep their cities in mind. You have done that, and we're very proud. Do you think you'll ever fight again in Omaha, Nebraska?
Probably not. To be honest, I told everybody last year that most likely was my last fight, and I meant it. And we had a great ride, and I put on for the city. I'm glad that I was able to bring big boxing events to Omaha, Nebraska. I'm glad that I put us on the map not only for boxing, but for support, because a lot of people doubted that Omaha would come out and support a big boxing event. So I'm just happy that I was able to be the one to, you know, do the things that I did in the sport of boxing for Omaha.
Terrence, being the greatest, what does it mean to break down all the stereotypes, especially from a kid from North Omaha, being the greatest?
Oh, man, it feels good. You know, a lot of people, they doubted that a person like Terrence Crawford, coming from, you know, North Omaha, with no big backing like the kids from New York, Texas, or California, or Philadelphia, and those big boxing hotbeds, can make it from a small town like Omaha, Nebraska. But I always tell people, it's not where you're from, you know, it's what you put in the sport, you know. So it's a great feeling, because a lot of people didn't give me the shot. A lot of people didn't believe in me. A lot of people, you know, said I had to move out of town to become champion. A lot of people tried to take me away from my coaches when I was a little kid. So for me to stay in my city and stay with the team that brought me here, got me here, it's wonderful, because I don't look at it like I won. I feel like we won.
Thanks, guys. We got to get going for the parade. Thank you for coming. Somebody from security will help you down to the 19th Street side exit, and then you can get to the parade location.